Thousands of people descended on Melbourne CBD last night to ring in 2024 and make the most of the New Year's celebrations and events. Live to Georgia Simpson now in Melbourne. Georgia, how did the night unfold?
Well, Kenny, the atmosphere in Melbourne CBD last night was at an all-time high. Melbourne's Lord Mayor Sally Capps said the city was just full of live music, which we love to see as Melbourne is known as Australia's live music capital. Around 500,000 people made their way into the CBD and surrounding areas to celebrate the end of 2023 and, of course, to ring in a brand new year, 2024. There were fireworks at 9:30 p.m. for those people, mainly families who couldn't make it till midnight. And then, of course, the grand finale at midnight with fireworks being launched from Melbourne's tallest skyscrapers into the midnight sky, dazzling all the revellers who had gathered to watch them from the CBD and around the banks of the Yarra River. It was really good to see, Kenny, on my way to work this morning, all the parks and gardens surrounding the celebration zones are really clean and tidy, which is quite remarkable when you consider that just hours ago there were thousands of people packed in these areas. Last night's celebration cost the City of Melbourne and the state government around $4.4 million, $400,000 more than the year prior. Whilst the celebrations in Melbourne went off without a hitch, unfortunately it did turn to disaster out in Melbourne's northern suburbs. A group in Mill Park out there was a backyard explosion which resulted in 11 people being taken to hospital, 8 of them reportedly with significant burns. Fortunately, they are all in a stable condition.
Georgia Simpson, thank you.